George Gerbil Review Story.
Gerbil reads. Gerbil reads. Gerbil reads.
George Gerbil's cage was lots of fun. Jump, take a turn, come on, let's run. George Gerbil did a jolly deed to help some families with a need.
George Gerbil took turns running across the bridge in his gerbil cage. George Gerbil took turns with his big sister, Ginger Gerbil. The two pudgy little gerbils took turns on the rolling wheel and the two gerbil tunnels too. After a while, George Gerbil and Ginger Gerbil heard a little bell go, ching, ching, ching. Mama Gerbil wanted George Gerbil and Ginger Gerbil to come to her. It was their special learning time. Mama Gerbil asked George Gerbil and Ginger Gerbil some fun questions. Mama Gerbil wanted George Gerbil and Ginger Gerbil to learn to think. Learning is fun, said George Gerbil and Ginger Gerbil joyfully. Mama Gerbil asked George Gerbil and Ginger Gerbil to think of a way that they could help needy or not having everything you need families. George Gerbil thought they could make joyful gerbil jelly. What a nice idea! So George Gerbil and Ginger Gerbil went to the berry patch. George Gerbil and Ginger Gerbil were picking large, juicy berries for jelly. While they were working, George Gerbil almost forgot to stay close to his big sister. A giant, hungry hawk almost grabbed George Gerbil. Then later, after the gerbils put four nice jars of jelly out on the porch to cool, the telephone jangled. Papa Gerbil called to give Mama Gerbil a message. A gentleman would soon drive up in his jeep. This gentleman needed four jars of joyful gerbil jelly for his family. But when George Gerbil went to check on the jelly, he gasped. Instead of four jars of jelly on the porch, there were only three. After that, every time the gerbil family made four more jars of jelly, one jar ended up missing. What was happening to the jars of jelly? Mama Gerbil asked Ginger Gerbil and George Gerbil to go outside to look for clues. George Gerbil and Ginger Gerbil looked everywhere. Before they knew what had happened, George Gerbil and Ginger Gerbil thought they were lost. Just then, George Gerbil and Ginger Gerbil heard, "Cheep! Cheep!" A policeman's whistle blew. "Cheep!" There, on top of an ant hill, stood an ant policeman. The ant policeman was directing ant traffic. There were ants, ants, and more ants. George Gerbil saw that each little ant was carrying luggage. George Gerbil found out that the ants were going to Jelly Mountain for a jolly holiday. The ants were going to fill their luggage with jelly. The ants needed enough jelly to feed them all through the long cold winter. "Just where is Jelly Mountain?" asked Ginger Gerbil. "Well, Jelly Mountain is right near your gerbil cage," said the ant policeman. "Oh, good! Now we know what happened to our jars of joyful gerbil jelly," exclaimed Ginger Gerbil. Each time we gerbils opened the cage door, a jar of jelly jiggled off the edge of the porch. Then it rolled into the grass. The jelly poured out of the jars and made a mountain of jelly. So George Gerbil and Ginger Gerbil marched safely home following the ants. Jeet, jeet, went the ant policeman's whistle as he directed traffic. George Gerbil exclaimed, "Our jelly job turned out just jolly."